Thank you so much. I'm Wendy Bagwell. The stuff that you've been hearing about me getting old and senile is ridiculous. I'm as suave right now as I was when I was 20 years old. The only problem I got is women. I'm surrounded with women. On the bus, it's women. When I get home, it's women. Never been around nothing but women, always telling me what to do. It finally catches up with you, and it's about to kill me. So, I'm dedicating this story to all the men in the world who, like me, is in their upper 40s. And total protection is killing them. I'm going to tell you something, and this is a fact with my hand up if I had to die. We were singing in a town called Sugar Creek, Ohio, a couple of weeks ago. I started the stage, and little Roy Lewis, most of you know who he is, ran up to me and said, "Hey, Wendy," said, you got thing good to eat in that garbage can on the bus?" Well, I knew instantly who he had been talking to. Geraldine and Jan, who for some reason gets a delight in telling people that I eat out of garbage cans. I'll tell you where that comes from. On the bus, we'll stop at McDonald's or somewhere and we'll get sausage, biscuits, whatever. Sometimes the girls, they eat a bite or two, roll it up in a paper, throw it in the trash. Well, that night after the show's over, ten or 11 o'clock at night, I get a little bit hungry, and I get them out of the trash can, not the garbage can, and it's wrapped up. There ain't nothing wrong with it. They make it sound like I reach down in a slop bucket and get through it. But it's wrapped up and there ain't nothing wrong with it. And if it happens to be the next day that I decide to eat it, then they start talking about bacteria. I said, "Don't worry about the bacteria. I eat it, chewed it up with the rest of it." But I absolutely hear salt, saturated fat, and cholesterol till I'm so sick of it I could die. I've about decided I don't like food. I just like salt, saturated fat, and cholesterol. Matter of fact, if they ever put it in patties, I'll buy it and fry it. I'll guarantee it. I'm going to tell you this, and it's a fact with my hand up, if I had to die where I'm standing. This is the truth. I came home the other day. I reached in the refrigerator and took out a carton of milk. My wife, Melba, whirled around and said, "Don't drink that." I said, "Why?" She said, "It'll clog up your arteries." I said, "Who said so?" She said, "The TV doctor said so." You know, growing up, all I wanted was a RC cola. But it was drink your milk. Drink your milk if you want to be big like your Uncle Edgar. Drink your milk. Now it'll clog up my arteries. I said, "Well, what did he say for me to drink?" She said, "Well, if you want to be smart about it." Now, I want you to know what that woman said to me. A woman that won't allow rubbing alcohol in the house because the last word says alcohol. whirled around to me and said, "Well, smart aleck, if you want to know," he said, "you should drink a little wine every day and clean out your arteries." I said, "Well, that makes sense. My Uncle Leonard could drink a little wine and clean out a bar." Cleaning out his arteries. Matter of fact, and this is a fact, if I had to die where I'm standing, this is the truth. My Uncle Leonard come home from the war, World War II, come home from the war, and he announced that he was a demolitions expert. All his life been nothing but a poor dirt farmer. Now he's the demolitions expert, and he announces that he's no longer going to farm, he's in the demolition business. Wasn't long till my Uncle Leonard started getting a little bit of work. Somebody would, like for instance, be digging a well. They run into a rock in those days. They had to have a demolitions man come blow out the rock so they could dig the well. Same thing applied to pit toilets. Everybody. everybody dug their own back then. And it wasn't long till my Uncle Leonard got a job. A fellow was digging a pit toilet. He got about 3 feet down, he hit rock. He come got my Uncle Leonard, they went over there. Well, now back then, they dig the pit. Preacher, you remember this. They dig a new pit, but they don't build a new outhouse. The outhouse that they've got, they bring and sit over the pit they dug. You remember? Some of you remember that. Okay, so my Uncle Leonard was to blow the rock out of the pit. My Uncle Leonard blew the rock out of the pit and blew the outhouse out of the county. That spot is now known as Buck Annon's Lake. As my pastor, Quinn Evans, always says, this and I'll close. You can say that I made all this up. First of all, I ain't smart enough to make nothing up. It's got to happen. You can say I made this up if you want to, but this is a fact with my hand up. I came down the other morning, reached in the refrigerator, and took out an egg. An egg. And my wife whirled around at me like a mad woman and said, "What are you going to do with that?" I said I hadn't fully decided. I said, "I ain't gonna lay it, it's already been laid." I said, "I think I'm gonna take it in there and sit on it. And when it hatches, I'm gonna start me a chicken farm. Gonna be the Wendy Bagwell chicken farm. Or either you go sit on it, we'll call it the Malba Bagwell." Let me tell you this. Let me tell you about eating. Everybody's all shook about eating. One day they say this will kill you. The next day they say this is what you need. You never know what to eat. I'm going to tell you. I told my wife about my Uncle Herschel. My Uncle Herschel ate for breakfast every single morning of his life. He ate a half a pound of fried fatback, grease gravy, eggs and biscuits. Every morning of his life, it never changed. He ate a half a pound of fatback for breakfast. for 35 solid years. He ate a half a pound of fatback for breakfast. My wife whirled around at me and said, "Well, why did he quit?" She thought she had me there. She thought she had me there. I said, "Because he died." And he'd be eating it today if he's still here. As my pastor, Quinn Evans, always says, about 30 minutes after he says, "I'll close with this." In closing, they got all over me to go have a physical. I said, "Well, ain't nothing wrong with me. They want me to go have a physical anyway." So I go to the doctor. I said, "I'm here to have a physical." He said, "All right, Mr. Bagwell." He said, "Have a seat over here if you would." And he got out his little thing there. And he said, "A few questions I want to ask you before you have the physical." I said, "Go right ahead, doctor. Anything you want to know?" He said, "Mr. Bagwell, are you a heavy smoker?" I said, "No, sir. I don't smoke." He said, "Check that right off." He said, "Mr. Bagwell, are you a heavy drinker?" I said, "No, sir, I never touch a drop." He said, "Well, Mr. Bagwell, you seem mighty proud to say that." He said, "Well, let me tell you something." He said, "A little bit of wine." "It's good for your arteries." I said, "Doctor, are you on television?"